Alright guys, welcome back to another video. I hope you guys are having a great day today. If life's not great, to make it back, because that's what we're about. So right now I am working on raising my car. I need it to be raised by maybe an inch, and I do want to go ahead and say, if you haven't hit that like button, go ahead and hit that like button now, because the video that follows after this, you really don't want to miss it. For more content on me working on my car and more content on the SI, just doing whatever and doing maybe hood rat stuff, I do recommend that, and I'm working on my language at the same time. And without further ado, tune in. So as I stated, I am raising my car, and this tool has really came in handy. Right now I'm about to disconnect my brake lines from the coilovers. These are max speeding rocks coilovers, and for the height that I wanted it at, these coilovers are great, and I had no complaints, and they handle really well. I'm just gonna be raising it just a little bit. So I'm going to go ahead and start working on this. I want to make use of it all the time, because I already know that their rear is gonna be a pain. So let's go ahead and hop right into it. Alright, got the front coilovers adjusted. It's kind of hard to see as it is now, but I did raise it up. It's even on both sides. It took like an hour to do, about 2 hours to do. Right now I'm working on the rear. I'm not gonna lie, I never did this before. As trying to raise a car up, because usually where I set it at is usually where I want it to be at. But these times are different. So right now I'm trying to get this down. I'm not sure how I'll go about this, but I'm really just trying to raise this car up in the rear. I'm trying to do my research and whatnot, but people love getting sidetracked. But so I'm gonna keep on tinkering with this. If I'll let you guys know what to do, if I figure something out. All right, so I managed to get the rear all raised up. I'm going to show you guys how I managed to get that done. And there are videos on YouTube about it, but I'm just going to share it from my perspective. So I got the passenger side all raised. Is you kind of see it? So I got two fingers here, two fingers here, and I still have one finger here, and the car is kind of lopsided. Yeah, I might have to readjust the front again, but it's better than what we started with. And still need to go get hose clamps so I can tighten this down so it's not just popping in and out, and I don't need any coolant spilling out anywhere. So go ahead and knock out the rear, and yeah, let's go ahead and get started.
I know it's part of the paint. All I know is this part was a bitch.
Alright, so I said I was going to show you guys what I had to do. This side gave me some problems because this ring, it was originally all the way up here. You see my finger? The ring was all the way up here. I lowered it about almost an inch. It's probably a little bit more, it's in the range of 1 inch. Pretty much what I do, break this loose. But before you even get to that step, or try and mess with the shop, depending on how low you are originally, I know for me, I was maxed out, max low, which means I was, for these coilovers, max low had me about tucking the tires on this car. I actually like that fitment. Pretty much, all I gotta do is spin this part. Now, people might say it's preload, one or the other affects preload. I don't know. This is what I found to work. All I did was turn this down and then keep pushing the collars down towards the ground in order to raise the car up. Then once you get that to where you wanted that to be at, adjust the shock accordingly. For me, since I did this, I put that down. Originally it was like almost like around an inch, but it was like a little bit too much. That put this at an inch and a half, and then I had to raise it back up to where it is currently, along with this. So right now I'm about to tighten this back up, double check the bolts, and this car is gonna be good to go as far as height is concerned. And all I gotta do is just get hose clamps for the throttle body and coolant hoses, and this car will be really set to go. Alright, got Nura all finished up. I went to go see if they had any hose clamps for this old grill, and they didn't. I had to go to Home Depot or something like that. But this weekend, I got to install my new throttle body and raise the car up, and as well as work on the Camry, which got some new headlights, which is looking icy. Sheesh. And she's looking good. She just needs a car wash, and I think that's it. And just, she's gonna repaint it soon, so it's not my car, but you know, gotta keep the love in the family. But yep, I'm really psyched. If you guys were looking to see the first drive, you guys can see that in the next video, because we're gonna get the car aligned and whatnot, and should be ready to go. So stay tuned and look forward to that. I'll catch you guys in the next video. If life's not great, tune to Mega Back, that's where we're about. And I'll catch you guys in the next one. Tune out. What's up, guys, and welcome back to the AW Vlog. Life's not great, tune to Mega Back, that's where we're about. And I'll catch you guys in the next one.